Hey everybody, it's Lavender Town.
And today we're going to be talking about Minecraft, the only game that I had to uninstall off of my computer during college because I was too addicted to it to finish my assignments. I wanted to draw some of the mobs from Minecraft. I really enjoy this game and it's constantly going between being really popular, settling down, and then becoming popular again. It's kind of one of those games that I feel like is going to be stuck with us into the far, far future. And of course, I had to start with the creeper because, let's face it, the creeper is the most iconic enemy type in Minecraft. There's something about them just sneaking up on you. You hear that little hiss and suddenly your house that you just worked on forever is now got a bit of a bite mark out of it and you might be dead. So the main thing I wanted to focus with on the creeper was getting the actual like personality of the creeper that I sort of imply, because while creepers do explode, their general attitude before they explode is actually very stealthy and quiet. So my first gut reaction to make that sort of a very like Junkrat explosive type character seemed not quite right. I actually wanted him to seem a little bit more almost shy or reserved, and then there's just like hints throughout that he's on the verge of just exploding into dust. I wanted to get the face right. That was a really key part for me. A lot of the mobs in Minecraft are kind of just like long like 3D rectangles. As for his pose, it's pretty like blocky. I tucked in his arms so that it has that sort of silhouette. And I decided to give him some goggles. Not only does that kind of allude to like the blasting of the explosion, but it also can be the shape of the creeper's eyes. So they're sort of like this dorky square shape. And as for the mouth, I had a lot of different ideas about how to implement that very famous frowning mouth, but in the end I decided to mostly just go with a normal frown and have piercings above and below the lip so that it kind of just fills out that silhouette a little bit more. I know it's kind of hard to read, but I feel like it still gives off that impression a little bit. I also gave him some little square freckles too, just because I thought it was cute. I popped on a creeper earring into his ear, and I also just tried to keep the like pixel patterning on the creeper all over his sweatshirt, and I put a little TNT sort of patch on the front of it as well, and put little burn marks throughout as if he's recently exploded. Next up is the Ghast. Now these little guys I have a really love-hate relationship with. I think that they're so cute actually. I actually like their little sounds. They're like, sounds. and I think the fact that they have like tear tracks running down their face is really adorable and sad. So I do really like them. However, when I'm in the Nether, there's nothing more stressful than wandering around and hearing the sound of them spitting fireballs at you. So for the Ghast, I definitely wanted this character to look really sad and gloomy, and sort of reserved as well, kind of like the creeper. They have a similar pose because I feel like they have a similar vibe. I wanted to do this character in sort of the passive Ghast position, but I definitely wanted to allude to the fireballs as well, especially because the color palette for the Ghast is so monochromatic. I mean, they really are just like little white weird squids, and especially since I kept her eyes closed, you can't really see that they're red. I wanted to have just little pops of the like fire color, because that's really all I had to work with other than like gray and white. So for the general silhouette, I wanted to give this character sort of like a very puffy torso area, so this puffy jacket worked nice for filling out that form. And then I did these weird little like, I guess, tassels at the bottom that form almost a sort of skirt. I just felt like that would actually have the shape of the Ghast the best that I could do. And I put an actual little Ghast on the zipper of the jacket as well. I know that's very literal, kind of like the creeper earring, but I just thought it was kind of a cute touch. So I also gave this character a little like puffy hat. Again, I'm just trying to make that sort of like blocky cube shape up at the top. It's a very top heavy design and I'm trying to just incorporate that as best as I can. And I couldn't help myself but give a little bit of warm sort of shading in the cheeks. I honestly think the gas turned out so cute. They definitely look really short as well, which I kind of intended because the gas, even though they are actually quite big, there's something about the proportions of the design against the face that make it look like it would be a really tiny character. So this character definitely gives me the impression that they would be quite the wallflower at a party. Very shy, very nervous, and very often sad. But there they are, all finished. Next up, I wanted to do the Iron Golem. I really love this design, and I didn't even realize until I started researching for this video, but the fact that the Iron Golems sometimes are carrying flowers is actually a reference to Castle in the Sky, which is one of my favorite animated movies. But generally, I just really love this design. I think it's so cute, and they're so like big and bulky, but then they have these delicate tendrils of like vines and flowers on them. So I immediately knew I definitely wanted to draw a really strong character, and I decided to go with a girl just because I felt like it was the obvious thing to do a big beefy himbo, but instead I just kind of wanted to subvert that a little bit, and so I made this big beefy girl, and I just generally wanted to design her very close to the actual Iron Golem's design. I mean, Iron Golems are definitely more humanoid than both creepers and gas, so this one was a little bit easier. I don't draw muscles that often, so hopefully I did a decent job. And I just really love this super like buff character holding this delicate flower. It's such a cute aesthetic. And I used a trick in Clip Studio to actually do these vines much more easily. It's called like border effect. You can do it on a layer, and it allows you to just draw the vines like. I mean, you can see how I'm doing it. You just draw them in and they are already like a white and black bordered line. That really makes it a lot easier. Anyway, the color palette is pretty simple. Again, it's very monochromatic, kind of like the Ghast. But in this case, there are pops of colors already sort of part of the design. So there's the nice green vines and the little yellow flowers that are coming out of them. And of course, the red eyes. I was tempted to do the black sclera that it appears that the Iron Golem has, but I decided against it. I thought that was too inhuman. And the goal of this is to turn them human. So I moved away from that. Though I did include the darkness under the eyes. That kind of looks like just eye bags. And I gave her a nice strong, well-acquainted set of brows, because the brow is very, very dense and uniform on the Iron Golem as well. And honestly, this one is my favorite. It kind of reminded me that I should like push out and try to do more different body types more often, just because it was so fun to paint and shade all of the muscles. Anyway, I think she's probably my favorite of the video. Next up is the Blaze. Now this is another Nether enemy, and these guys always scared the crap out of me. I hated coming across them. They're, they're always firing fireballs at you, and it's just, they're really frenetic and out of control, and they can fly. The main thing about the Blaze is obviously all of these blaze rods that are swirling around them. And at first I was very concerned about these weird floating disembodied rods and trying to fit that into the character design, but in the end I kind of just put them in this character's hands. I honestly think that I wanted to make them look really like young and sort of kiddish, like a kid you wouldn't want to be in the same restaurant as you, you know, someone who's gonna kick the back of a car seat if you're driving with them, just a total like terror to be around. Primarily based on like, I don't know, the level of which I get annoyed with them when I come across them in Minecraft. And also because, yeah, they just seem a little more frenetic than most of these other enemies that I had in here. I wanted to keep the color palette obviously really warm. Ghasts have a basically just like yellow and orange and brown color palettes with black smoke in the center. So for the black smoke, I gave this character like a weird fluffy sort of vest that was gonna be really dark. And then everything else is really focused around trying to emulate those blaze rods. For the hair, I actually wanted it to be sort of like shaggy and in the character's face, because if you look at the face and head of a blaze, it kind of almost looks like they have like shaggy hair coming down. It's actually more like a golden gradient down to the darker part of the face, but to me it kind of looked like hair when I, you know, squint at it for this challenge. I just tried to get the energy up on this character. All of the other mobs are a little bit more subdued. The ghast seems really shy, the creeper's really quiet, and the golems are a little stoic until they're, of course, like punching you directly in the face. In general, yeah, this is definitely like the firecracker character of the bunch. I decided to shade with warm colors as well, just to keep it really, really warm, and I put the little blaze rods also on the cheeks as sort of a last decoration. So what do you guys think of my humanized Minecraft mobs? Let me know if you think I got their essence correct in their character design, and who your favorite was. And thank you so much for watching till the end. I'll see you in the next one. Thank you so much to my patrons, including Rylan, Kadaria, Something Super, Deadly Nightshade, Maria Vasquez, Astral Fox Art, Middle Z, Alcapa, Lily Allure, The Expressive Poker Face, Marissi Axolotl, Chris Draws, Kai Kizer, Tsubaki, Snow White, The Becky, Liliana Hammond, Mia Lavalie, Angel File, Cutie Pie, Nicole Ludwak, Nicolette Queen, Rainwater Pearls, Ice Cream Pal, Lion, Alaria Louie, Nora Cornelson, Cola, Rachel Singh, Yaboyas T, JJ Jade, and of course, blah, 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 blah.